Hi guys, in this video I am going to discuss about Fibonacci oscillation C using for loop. So right here, for example, enter the number 5. So Fibonacci numbers are 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. So 0 plus 1, that is 1, 1 plus 1, 2, and 1 plus 3, 1 plus 2 will display 3. And next number 2 plus 3, so next number will 5. So let's write code in C language. So first include stdio.h. we have to write, and next write has include conio.h. so let's write main function void main. So add here declare variable int a equal to 0, b equal to 1, c comma n and 10. So now write printf function to display message into output screen, enter the number. So by using a scanner function, that will store the enter number %d, because that is a number in integer type, and ampersand I am using to store number into particular address. Now let's write for loop for C start from 0, condition of C less than n, and C++. And now let's write inside of for loop if give the condition C less than equal to 1, then temp equal to C, or else part temp equal to A plus B, and A equal to B, and now B equal to temp. So from here, write again printf function percent d slash m comma temp, and now the last write getch function. So let's save that code into C language, because the code is written in CPP, pp.c, so it's converted into C language. Now let's compile. So there is no any error. So let's write run the code. So now enter any number. So this time, so at here, 10, enter number 10. So Fibonacci number displaying to 10, 0 plus 0, 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 5, 8, 8 plus 13, 21, 13 plus 21, 34. So this is the Fibonacci number. So if you want to display the Fibonacci number till 15, so this is all number till 15th Fibonacci series. So here from to remove a previous output screen, so let's write clear CLRSTR function. So now run again. So at here I am getting error. The error message declaration is not allowed. Okay, then let's declare it. After a variable declaration CLR SCR, and now compile. So it's error gone, and now enter the number. So this time previous output screen doesn't come. So integer number 7, so from any number till 7, this is our displaying. Now from here I'm going to discuss about the way of execution of this program. So first is hasIncluded stdio.h, standard input output. So this two function is related with that one. If you want give this one, then the error will come. The function has prototypes like this error. And for after that, conio hasIncluded conio.h. So that is related with getCH function. And if I am using clear function, so both comes under. Both the definition is already written conio dot h header file. So now control comes to main method. Here after that will go inside, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variable is there. So first is a, and second b, and third c, and next n, and temp. So a value initialized to 0, b value 1, and rest not. After a clear screen, so if any output screen already present in the outputs, so by using clear screen that will terminate the previous output screen, and that will refresh. That will show the presently output screens. Not previously. So hereafter printer enter the number, so that message come to output screen because I'm using printer function scanf that will take integer type of value to store into some particular address by using ampersand. And if I'm going to give the value n, so n I'm going to give 5. So here hereafter control comes to this position for c equal to 0. So c value initialized to 0. That will check the condition c less than n. C less than means 0 less than 5. Condition okay, then that will go inside. If c less than equal to 0, c value is 0 less than equal to 1. So c value is 0 and less than 1. So absolutely condition is true, then that will go inside temp or c value. Now go to temp. So c value is now 0, and if the condition is true, so that won't go to else part again. From here that won't go to else part, and add here printf %d temp. So whatever the value 0, that will print. And hereafter, that will again control go at there, c gonna increase by 1. So again, that will check if c less than equal to 1, means 1 equal to 1 condition true, then c value goes to temp. And that won't go to the else part, so here that will print temp value. So again, c gonna increase by 1. So this time c become 2. So at here, 2 less than 1, that is not true. So that will go else part. At here, temp equal to a plus b. Temp value equal to a plus b, 0 plus 1, 1. So at here, temp become 1 again. And b value go to a. So b value is now 1, that will go to a. And temp value go to b. Temp value is now 1, that will go to b. So hereafter that will, as part finish, then that will print printer whatever the temp that will print. Again the control go and increase the value of c. So c is now this temp 3. So here that will check the condition 3 less than 5, condition true. So at here that will go inside 3 less than 1, condition false. So that will go as part. Temp equal to a plus b. So a plus b means a value is now 1 and b value is now 1. 1 plus 1, 2. And b value go to a. So b value is now 1 and temp value go to b. Temp value 2, that will go to b. So hereafter printf tam, so that we print. Again c gonna increase by 1, so c is now this time 4. So enter that will check condition 4 less than 5, condition true, that will go inside. That will check if condition, so 4 less than 1 condition false, then again that will go as part. So this time time equal to a plus b. So a plus b means 2 plus 1, so 3. And b equal to a, so b value become go to a, and our time value go to b, so time value is 3. So hereafter that will go inside temp, print of temp, that will print. Again the value gonna increase by 1, so 4 plus 1, 5. So that will check condition 5 less than 5, condition false. So hereafter that will condition false, so then thereafter that will go out of for loop. And from here getch function is there, getch. So that will take one input from the screen. After that will terminate the program. So that final output 0, 1, 1 and 2, 3. If I am going to give value 6, then that will check if this time C value is now 5. So 5 less than 6 condition true, then that will this part won't be executed because the value of C is now 5. So hereafter as part temp equal to a plus b, so at here temp value a plus b means 2 plus 3, 5, and b value go to a, so b value is now 3, so this will come there, and temp value go to b. So at here after this that will control comes to printf and that will print if I give the value 6. And this time 6 not equal to 6, so then again gonna increase the value of c, so 6 become 6, 6 less than 6, condition false, then that will take one input from the keyword and terminate the output screen. So final output this one. If the value 6 c value 6, then the display 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5. If c value 5, then that will display 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. So I hope guys you understand the driver method of this program. So leave your comment and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.